Hello, welcome to our DrChrono tutorial. DrChrono has partnered with CoverMyMeds to implement a new electronic prior authorization enhancement, or EPA. The improvement allows for a prior authorization to be submitted to the payer directly from the Send ERX page, making it quicker for a patient to immediately begin or continue treatment with as little delay as possible. This video will demonstrate how to do so. Let's begin. First, a prescription benefits check will need to be performed for the patient via the eligibility tab. This information is needed for SureScripts to obtain. Once the benefit prescription summary is appearing, you can then navigate to Send ERX. It is important to fill out the following fields in order for their system to determine if a prior authorization is required: medication, instructions, dispense, dispense unit, day supply, and diagnosis code. It is important to note that only pre-existing problems will populate in the diagnosis code. You can also navigate to the patient's problem list to add additional codes. After filling in the required fields, if the medication requires a prior authorization, the following buttons will appear: Initiate Standard Request or Initiate Urgent Request. Initiating an urgent request requires the payer to provide a response in a specific time frame, typically within 24 hours. Once the request has been initiated, you will receive a pop-up message that the request has been sent. Now navigate to the Message Center and to the Prior Authorization section to start the PA request process. Please note, all responses will be housed in the Prior Authorization section within the Message Center. It does typically take about 1 to 2 minutes for the request to appear in the Message Center, however, it is based upon the payer. As we wait, let's review some other responses that you may receive from the payer, such as closed. A reason will be provided with the note stating why the PA request has been closed. You can also view the patient's PA from this message. You can also review more PA questions as a response. The payer gives the option to click on more questions to complete that response in order for you to then submit that PA request. Now that our PA request has appeared in the Message Center, let's go ahead and click Start PA. We will click Start PA request. Clicking the Start PA request radio button will navigate to the questionnaire page located within the patient's chart under Demographics and the Authorizations tab. As you fill out the questionnaire, field dropdowns will appear based on the previous response. There's also an option to attach documentation if needed, and then submit PA request. As stated, payer responses will be forwarded to the prior authorization section in the Message Center. The response time is based on each specific payer. Let's take a look at a few example responses, such as approved. The payer has approved this request. More questions. The payer requires additional information, which can be answered by clicking the More Questions button. Closed or denied. There is a note included providing the reason for denial. To view a list of patients' prior authorization outside of the Message Center, you can do so via the patient's chart under Demographics and the Prior Authorization tab. Here you can locate the medication and prior authorization status. There's also an actions column to send, cancel, or archive a PA request. This concludes demonstrating how to send an electronic prior authorization using the CoverMyMeds integration. I hope that this video was helpful. If you need additional assistance, please reach out to our support team at drchrono.com.